welcome to October Spookfest. Our first review of this month is The Bride of Chucky. Okay, I'm not going to be doing this entire interview. Oh man, this is bad.
What a crock.
But then again, if it wasn't, I wouldn't be reviewing it, now would I? Now, I barely remember anything from the first three Chucky movies, because I've always found the idea of a homicidal doll to be fucking hilarious.
Yeah, I remember Child's Play. It was a freaking joke and an embarrassment to horror movies everywhere.
You know, a Cabbage Patch Kid with an attitude.
You stupid you filthy slut!
It's a freaking doll, people. We're running away from dolls.
Not scary. At all.
He's this tall. I could beat you up, Chucky.
I don't really know why I started with The Bride of Chucky, but I did. And I'm not reviewing the first three, either. I might review The Seed of Chucky, I'm still debating, so don't get your hopes up. Maybe because I want to, maybe just because they'd be easy to review. I'll never tell. So, to brief you, if you're not familiar with Chucky, in the first three films, he was going after a kid named Andy. Because Andy was the first person that Chucky revealed himself to as a possessed doll, he must use a counter curse on Andy to take Andy's body in order to become human again.
I can't wait to be human again!
Even though one of the major plot points in the first two films, they axed it completely in the third, is that the longer he stays in the doll's body, the more human he becomes. So he bleeds and drunk. Yet it takes fucking forever to kill the little shit! And oh yeah, isn't he trying to become human anyway? Or is it really just the height that's the problem? And being plastic. Either way, they drop both Chucky needing Andy to become human again, and obtaining human traits the longer he stays in the doll's body in The Bride of Chucky. So now you're basically caught up. Oh, I also forgot to mention that he's very self-destructive, meaning he fails constantly at becoming human again, because of his own stupidity. And now, in this one, he has a bride's stupidity to add to the mix, though their wedding wouldn't be recognized as legal in any state, or country, for that matter, so technically they aren't even married. Oh, whatever, let's just get started, shall we? Nothing has happened yet, and already the music is eerie. Ooh, so spooky. Spooky. Seriously, guys? The eerie music is just a cheap trick to make a movie that is absolutely not scary, scary. But guess what? It doesn't work! Oh my god, does every horror movie have to begin at night during a thunderstorm? Or at least every Chucky movie?
They haven't all started at night with a thunderstorm.
Well, it certainly feels that way. Oh my god, is that... No. The villain. Touché. Oh my god, I just noticed Freddy's glove. Are you shitting me, movie? Chucky is already laughable enough. You don't have to remind audiences of the better horror movies that they could be watching instead. And how did this police station obtain all of these items? Movie, are you trying to imply that all of these different franchises happen in the same fucking town? What the flying fuckity fuck? How would this police station have all these items? Okay, you're fired for stealing evidence.
Hey, I'm on my way, and don't forget my money.
See you soon, Bailey. Don't you forget.
This is why you don't talk on cell phones and bribe, dipshit.
Curiosity killed the cat.
How would she have known what locker they had Chucky in? How does one obtain this information unless you're a cop or a detective or something? Oh, she's a bad girl. She murdered a cop with her nail file and then she used it without even wiping it off. Bad. Have you never seen one before? Jesus. Damn it, Rob Zombie! Stop showing up in these dreadful flicks! Yes! Rob fucking Zombie! Don't make me review one of your horror flicks, cause I will! Probably. Maybe. We'll see. Katherine Heigl? Jesus Christ, no wonder this movie sucks.
Shut up, Katherine Heigl, you stupid liar!
I'm not sorry for that last joke. At all. Still got a review to do. Oh, right. Review. Okay. So she likes dolls and is oddly obsessed by Chucky's story, so much so that she's even framed some of the article cutouts. Even I've never done that with Gwen Stefani. Instead, I just put her in a binder like a normal person. Forgive me if I'm being rude, blame my ever-changing mood. I know that it's true, that I know that it's you. You are my heaven. Oh, what can I see that you're so good for me? You are my heaven. Designer love maker, I wanna give you she fixes Chucky and seductively lays on her bed. Fucking psycho. Meanwhile, back to the Andy replacements. Oh God, no! Why? Why? Pourquoi? Pourquoi? Why is it always the good comedians? Pourquoi? And he answers the door in a uniform. Wow. Hello. I'm trying to intimidate you because you're taking out my daughter. Oh, I'm sorry. It's actually his niece.
What are you going to study?
Theater arts.
Mm-hmm. But on an athletic scholarship, right? Playing hockey?
No! The world doesn't revolve around sports. Thespians do more for the world than athletes. You want an example? No one fucking riots over movies or plays.
What about Twilight?
That hardly constitutes as anything, really. Wow, Katherine Heigl. You look like such a baby. Oh my god, you're so cute. I just want to pinch your cheeks. You're so cute. So, Theater McFigure Skater David here is just a front to conceal the guy Jade is actually going out with from her uncle. I'm assuming her parents fell ill from the dreaded off-camera disease. Come on now, she's gotta know that he'd just have an officer following her.
She just left.
Yep. But did you have to say so creepily, like you're the one that's going to fucking murder her?
David made quite an impression. I think Warren's in love.
Yuck. Not my type. I'm so over that whole uniform thing.
They made the theater kid gay? Oh, so he's in theater and he's a guy, so he must be gay. I will fucking murder you all. I'm starting to think that Chucky isn't the one we should be worried about. This cop has creep written all over him.
But I'm a creep. I'm a little.
Precisely.
Gotcha.
And you got me. Let's do it again. This time, you hide. Will burn you alive, Hollywood. I really will. A pentagram is not evil, and paganism is not the work of Satan, you asswipes. The 5 points of a pentagram represent the 5 elements, earth, air, fire, water, and spirit. Paganism is more earthy and natural than it is supernatural. To put it in layman's terms for you ignorant and closed-minded viewers, paganism is more about celebrating Earth and life in all its beauty. Why do you think the spring solstice and winter solstice exist? To celebrate and acknowledge the changing seasons.
Dumbula, give me the power, I beg of you. Dumbula.
I'm sorry. All I hear is boobs coming out of your mouth. Boobs. 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 See? What'd I tell you?
Awake! 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 Awake!
It seems like the chant is ineffective, but isn't that always how it goes in these types of movies?
Hey, Tiffany!
And the stereotypes just get better and better! Not like I'm not a walking stereotype. I'm so hot.
Hey, check it out!
What?
Check it out.
What is it?
Just fucking look at the Polaroid! Christ. This is Damien. He's Tiffany's boyfriend, though she clearly views him as expendable. Evidently, you get cool points with Tiffany if you've killed someone.
Oh my god. Oh my god, you really did a number on him, didn't you? What did you use? Was it really bloody? Did he scream a lot?
As I said a few minutes ago. Fucking psycho.
You never really actually killed anybody, did you? Did you? Did you, you pathetic worm?
Come on, Tiff, I'm working up to it.
I love how most of the pentagram is messed up, as you'd imagine it would be. But then there's like that perfect little chunk cut out of the bottom of it, ever so nicely.
See if my lipstick is under the sofa there. Back on your knees. Crawl. Good boy.
I love her. I really do.
How long have we been going out for now, huh?
What?
Don't you think you've kept me waiting long enough?
No.
Dude, you're a fucking idiot. Can't you tell that you're a fucking patsy to her? And I don't believe that you could seduce a flea.
You know what the French call an orgasm? Le petit morte.
The small death? Well, considering you're a fucking idiot, I think I'm gonna say no. I think it's just a cognate, meaning it means the same and is spelt about the same as it is in English, just with an extra letter tied to the end, so orgasme. My French is very limited, but as I said, I'm not gonna base my information off of what this asshat says.
He's so 80s.
No,
he's
not.
He's scary.
Yes, he is.
Look at him. You look at that punk. You looking at me?
Well, you've just killed yourself. Congratulations!
Are you ready for a menage a trois?
What's that?
Yeah, okay, he doesn't even know what menage a trois means. I doubt he knows what orgasm is in French. And who the fuck doesn't know what menage a trois means? This movie came out in 1998, so I was 12, and I probably could have told him.
Now you watch me. Both of you.
Where did her dress go? When did she change?
There's something I never told you about Chucky. He has a very bad temper. You see, we lived together for years. Boy, was he ever jealous. Anybody even looked at me, Chucky would take care of him. God, was he an incredible lover. He was the best I ever had.
Come on, baby. He ain't big enough to take care of a woman like you.
Oh, dear. Now you've done it. Yeah. Ow, my snake bites! I'm not even sure you'd bleed that much from doing that. But I'm not gonna test it. Nice undies, number one. Number two, turn your fucking head! The doll doesn't weigh enough to actually hold down that pillow to suffocate anyone! Back with Catherine. Pouring out, but her makeup is perfect. Oh, Hollywood.
Jade, when you're 18, you can go to hell for all I care, but until then, I'm stuck with you.
Jesus Christ, you're an asshole!
You can't keep us from seeing each other. I'm the chief of police, sport. I can do whatever I want.
Sounds like Sheriff Joe. If you live in Arizona, you'll get it. If you don't, Google is your friend.
You weren't gonna ask me to marry you?
What are you, fucking nuts?
You thought...
changed. You'll never change. The hell was I thinking?
Now the first thing we gotta do is get me out of this body once and for all.
No. I think I prefer you like this. You're kind of cute. You're just like a little baby. It's a little baby tickly. Itty. Okay. Mommy's tired. Time to go to sleep.
Oh, yes. I love her a lot. Really? You weren't even gonna uncuff him and at least throw him on the floor? The next morning, Tiffany finally attempts to dispose of Damien using a trunk to conceal him.
Jesse! Honey, could you give me a hand with this?
Yeah, okay, just a second.
Thanks, sweet face. I owe you one.
Sweetheart, he's supposed to be in high school. Please keep your libido in check. Please. When she gets doctor isn't even there.
I think it would do you good to settle down.
Babe, this is great. You won't regret it, I promise. What's that?
Your bride. Oh, Chucky, she's beautiful.
Oh my god, I love Tiffany! She is my kind of girl. The bar's moved. The crib isn't even that strong. Really? A plastic fucking ring that came with the doll? Oh, I give up on trying to find any sort of realism in this fucking film. I mean, it's about a fucking murderous doll who has been killed multiple times and yet still exists. So what the fuck was I thinking? Thank you! It's like what everybody's been wanting to do to him. But of course, it doesn't help as she gets electrocuted. It's a big bathroom for a single wife.
Andale, forte, forte, timbala! Awake!
I love the fucking bubbles! Fucking bubbles, bitch! God, Tiff, you look like shit as a doll. So Tiffany and Chucky need to get to New Jersey to get an amulet that was buried with Chucky's human body. They need the amulet in order to transfer their souls back into a human body. In order to get to Jersey, Tiffany calls Jesse and asks him to drive the dolls there for a friend, and he'd be paid for it. She can't go because she's helping a friend.
He is mentally incapacitated.
Please deliver dolls to caretaker's office, Forest Creek Cemetery, Hackensack, New Jersey. Love and kisses, Tiffany. Cemetery.
Seems legit.
Right. I'd do anything for you. Anything at all. You know that, right? Right?
Honey, if anyone is a jerk off, it's you.
Who the hell is this bozo? What's he doing?
Screwing with our ride, that's what. Ah, what the hell, I need the exercise.
Were you born with that knife super glued onto your hand or what?
No, because it came from your house.
Drag yourself into the 90s. Stabbings went out with Bundy and Dahmer. You look like Martha Stewart with that thing.
Who the fuck is Martha Stewart?
My idol?
I told you all! Martha Stewart was the devil! I told you! But you all said I was crazy! Now who's crazy?
Now!
This feels oddly shameful and undignified since he's now deceased. Two fucking dolls can lift John Ritter.
Going somewhere?
Fucking creepy, you make my skin crawl! Ugh!
Or does my uncle pay you extra?
Extra? It's nothing personal, at least on my part. But the money.
Wow! Could you be any more slimy? I mean, even Brad Dourif, who plays Chucky, doesn't act like this! And he plays a motherfucking homicidal doll!
Shut up! Oh. Shut up,
we're
trying to fucking
vaporize
you!
With what? This isn't a sci-fi movie, and you aren't Marvin the Martian.
You can't be too careful with guns.
And brava, you threatened and hit a cop. Well done. There's a cop right outside the van. In what way does this seem like a good idea? This is why you fail, because you actually thought to yourselves, we could lose our ride and blow our cover. Perfect time to light one up. Okay. I've never smoked pot, but I'm thinking it probably leaves some kind of scent in a confined space. So that just seems like a rational conclusion, but whatever. To throw the cop off the trail of checking the compartment they have Warren in, Chucky tosses the bag of pot to the side. The cop, of course, finds it.
Shit!
Nice job. Get Jade and get out now while the creepy cop is calling it in. Go! Why is he calling? He's not that tall.
Rude fucking doll.
Why? What was the fucking point? So Chucky blows up the police cruiser with the cop inside it.
There they are! Call the police!
Shit, go! Jesse, drive, go!
Why are Jade and Jesse so worried? Those people all gathered there to fucking toke up. Do you really expect me to believe that the cops would actually believe that? So, why are you gathered here to begin with? Not to smoke pot. That's for sure. Yeah. Seems legit.
Hello? What the fuck? David, I don't know what to tell you. I don't know what the hell is going on around here.
They've been on the road this long, and they're still rushed? We're meant to believe that the cops are that fucking fast. Definitely didn't take place in Detroit, that's for sure. Oh, whatever! I've lived there! I can say that! Good, I'm so glad Warren is starting to bleed out now.
We are gathered here tonight to celebrate the union of two people.
Nice to see they don't ID at this chapel. That's convenient. And Chucky jams out to a rock song. Though it looks more like if your grandmother tried to rock out to this kind of song. Ugh. What the who, where, and how?
For better or worse. For richer or poorer.
Romantic.
These kids have to be considered armed and extremely dangerous.
On what grounds? Based off what evidence?
Oh! Excuse me, the door was open. I didn't realize there was anybody in here.
What the fuck? Who the hell are you? You're coming late into the movie. I suspect you're not gonna last very long.
Oh. Well, I don't like him at all.
You know, you two really make a delicious-looking couple. Hey, Diane, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, yeah, you're real discreet. Where the fuck did she conceal that before she tucked it into her man's pocket? Ew.
Yeah, baby, come on.
You haven't even penetrated her yet! You're doing it wrong!
Huh?
Oh my god, what a doofus response! She looked lethal! Might be good time to scream! Huh? When Chucky and Tiffany snuck in, did they shut the door behind them as well? Because otherwise, I think, if the rooms are conjoined, then Jade and Jesse would have heard them screaming.
I love you.
Ugh, I hate this fucking scene. Doll's fucking cinematic masterpiece.
Do I detect a note of sarcasm?
Are you kidding me? This baby is off the charts.
I'm crying. I wonder if all the plumbing works.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm starting to feel like Pinocchio here.
Oh.
I am anatomically correct, you know.
Sure. They do it for a good guy doll. But Barbie and Ken can't catch a fucking break. And no. Even if you both are anatomically correct, there'd still need to be holes. Oh, God. I am analyzing this way more than I need to be.
Have you got a rubber?
Have I got a rubber?
Yeah.
Tiff!
What?
Look at me! I'm all rubber!
Oh, that's right.
Thank you, movie, for just unraveling what you're trying to do and thus making your major plot twist null and void.
Are you okay?
No. I'm married.
You've already gone to middle-aged housewife mode? I think you skipped a few steps.
I'm really scared. I think maybe he did it, David.
Why the hell did you marry him? Jesus!
Yoo-hoo! Anybody here? Housekeeping!
No! God damn it, not Kathy Nunchi! No! I love Hocus Pocus and just... God damn it, no! Okay, how did he get there so fast?
You're assuming Warren's dead. He's only missing.
You are so wrong.
Honey, this ain't no dirty socks.
I actually thought that you could kill someone.
I know, I'm so sorry.
Great, he's gonna die.
Hey, help! Over here!
Nobody move!
Well, that wasn't how I expected him to die. But I still called it!
So how did you end up like this?
Well, it's a long story.
It sure is.
In fact, if it was a movie, it would take 3 or 4 sequels just to do it justice.
No. We could get this done in one movie.
Report. The Jesse and Jade case keeps getting weirder and weirder. Fingerprints discovered at 2 separate crime scenes have been identified as belonging to Charles Lee Ray, the notorious serial killer gunned down in 1988. Now, police confirm that Ray's corpse will be exhumed from a Hackensack, New Jersey cemetery sometime today.
Every cop within 500 miles is looking for this van. We need something inconspicuous, but with a little style.
Not much of a housekeeper, is she?
Tiff!
Hmm?
Those dishes aren't gonna wash themselves, you know.
You were nice enough to cook for him. The least he could do is wash the dish.
What would Martha Stewart say?
Fuck Martha Stewart! Martha Stewart can kiss my shiny plastic butt!
Yes! I don't think he would have weight enough to break through the glass. You left the stove on? Tisk tisk. What would Martha Stewart say?
Fuck Martha Stewart!
Jesse gets Jade out of the RV before it bursts into flames from exposed wires. Are you fucking kidding me? No! No. Move on. Move on. I'm not even going to touch on how fucking stupid that was. So move on. Go on. Next scene. Really? One guy is exhuming Chucky's grave? Well, this was a priority case, wasn't it? I mean, they're in a real fucking hurry, aren't they? Well, that doesn't look fake at all.
Oh, bitch! You broke my neck!
Like you need it now? Sweetheart, you looked worse in the first film. Or do you not recall? Slowest knife ever. Tiffany stabs Chucky, but if you've seen any horror movie, you know that he's not down for the count just yet, and they fight it out. What did she expect bringing him back to life? Did she really expect a happy ending? It's fucking Chucky! Ladies, some guys can't be saved.
Go ahead and shoot! I'll be back! I always come back!
Yes, we know. And it's starting to get really fucking annoying.
You two go on home and stay put.
Let's go.
Two things. How are they getting home? And Jesse was stabbed in the fucking back. With a pretty big knife. Gee, I'm glad that magically went away.
Jesus.
Trust me. He had nothing to do with this abomination. Especially with what's about to occur. I don't even think we can blame the Dark Lord for having anything to do with this abomination. Okay. Here it goes. She has no reproductive organs! It hasn't even been 9 months! Chucky wouldn't have any sperm, she wouldn't have any eggs, nothing about this is even remotely possible! It's a fucking cheap and uncreative trick so they can make an even shittier sequel! 6 years later! It isn't clever, it hurts my fucking brain! Fuck! Good God almighty, this movie is terrible! But I don't believe that any of the Chucky movies are all that good. They're all fucking laughable to me.
You did have to laugh, come on.
It's a fucking doll. Just step on it. And that should be the end of it.
It's a doll. Step on it. It's over.
Like right now is the end of this review. Until next time. Bonnie. Dead, I am the